So Jami was gone this last weekend in Pennsylvania, and we have found that we love thrifting, junking, finding treasures everywhere we go.
This video, we're going to share with you some tips and tricks on how to junk while you're traveling, as well as share some of the places I went junking in Pennsylvania.
Okay, so I'm in Pittsburgh without Zeb, and I bought this chair. It was only $4, and I bought a trunk to get it home. So comment below if you think Zeb's going to be amused when he picks me up at the airport when I show up with a giant trunk with a chair in it.
Tip number one. Pack an extra suitcase.
A lot of times I'll fly Southwest or Delta. They let you bring one or two checked bags. I can travel really light, and so I will take my carry-on, only pack in that, and then I put my carry-on inside my big suitcase, so that way I have an entire suitcase to fill. Also, always remember brown packing paper, tape, and bubble wrap. If you've got extra space inside your suitcase, inside a suitcase, you can put those items inside of that, so that way you're ready to pack.
So this package was one of her checked bags, and it survived a transfer too.
So in Pennsylvania, I wound up stopping at Construction Junction, Goodwill, and a few different adorable shops in Brooksville, Pennsylvania, that are right on Main Street. And one of the things that I found is that everywhere has different values on things. I was a little bit sad because I did find a giant trunk that I fit a chair in, and it was 2 inches too big to fit on the airplane, which is why this happened, because all of these items were inside the trunk, packaged neatly, and I was like, you know what, even if they don't make it, it's better than leaving them behind like the trunk. So I just made my best effort to package them all up while people were laughing and giggling behind me.
I'm skeptical to see what's alive in here. What's in here? Do you have glass and stuff in here?
There is some glass, but on the bottom there's sealing tin. So that kind of gave it some rigidity on the bottom. I don't recommend this. It would be better to be inside of a suitcase, but in my case, where it was pack it and tape it or leave it, I chose to pack it with the brown paper and tape that I had. Here's a tip about the outside. You can tape the tag on, but also write your name and phone number on the brown paper if you ever have to package like this, because tags tend to fall off. So that gives it some extra assurance that your junk will make it back with you.
It's like Christmas.
I used every last bit of brown paper that I had. So this is all milled glass, which looks like it might have arrived alive. These we got at Goodwill, $5.99 for two of them. I'm gonna wind up putting them in the house. I love like the old school look here, so we can put them as towel bars. And then I went to Construction Junction and got these spindle people. The guy was like, what are you gonna do with those? And I'm like, well, hopefully the guy that made them won't be sad. I'm probably gonna paint them and then like make them all solid and cool and put a hook on them for wreath hangers. These are $5 each. And then
this is some big milk glass. We don't have milk glass like this out here.
That's why I junk everywhere, because you just never know what you're gonna find.
All we get is like the little vases and occasionally like a small bowl or something.
Yeah, these were $6 each at Goodwill. I found a few other fellow junkers while I was at the Goodwill, and it was super fun. The Goodwill is actually where I found my giant trunk that was 2 inches too big. So make sure if you're gonna do anything oversized and you're gonna pay extra, which I was going to, that you measure it, because I was 2 inches overall too big, and that's Fenton. Cool. I wasn't able to bring the trunk home, which is why we have this, but it is what it is. The guy that did my curbside check, and I told him he could keep the trunk and the chair. He was super sweet.
That's fancy.
Yeah, these I got from, there's a store in Brooksville, Pennsylvania. It's on the side of Main Street. It didn't have a name, but it was across from the car dealership. And he had a bunch of junk. I paid $5 for this Fenton. I think this is a flowered frog, because it's got these holes in it.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
And then it was $5 for the pair of these candlesticks, which I love this style. Right. He also threw in a little candy dish that's somewhere around here. One of my other pro tips is if you've got like some small but heavy items, think about putting them in your carry-on, because then you won't go over your overall weight for your suitcase. Yeah, that's another one of those.
Someone's already been planting with that one outside.
Isn't that cool?
Let me get this mess of packing material.
One of my favorite places that we went was Construction Junction. That's where I got this tin from. They were $5 each for these and $2 for the one on the bottom. And where we live, this is extremely hard to find. It's not super common, and these are gonna sell for around $20 to $25 a piece. We can even frame them out, put some hooks on the bottom, and turn them into some upcycled art and repaint them to be fun. So I definitely wanted to pick these up. They had bigger ones, I knew it would be difficult to get home. When you're packing, size matters. So think about things that are flat. Also think about things you can pack inside of to make the most use of your space. Make sure you're bubble wrapping and layering each item so that way it arrives alive. Also, if things are heavy, remember that you may want to separate those out into like carry-ons or even your backpack, because you have to be within a certain amount of weight. This is what I was talking about. These are really heavy irons, so I put one in my mom's carry-on and one in my carry-on, so that way they would still not be over the weight limit, because they definitely weren't worth going over. I paid $5 each. I'll sell them for probably $24 for the pair of irons.
I think those are really cool.
Yeah, they'll work really good for like bookends.
Yeah, they're heavy. Fun little frame.
Picked that up at Construction Junction. It was like $2, I think. And then this was free because the lid was broken.
Oh.
And this is another pro tip. If you've got lids to things, make sure you tape them down so they don't jostle around. This was actually shoved in my mom's suitcase because I was out of space and weight. She's like, I thought you just put one thing in my suitcase. There was a few.
Oh, I see where the broken is. Just sand it a little.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It's super pretty. And it has like weird paint on the outside, so we'll clean that off.
It's probably one of those specialty ones where they're like hand painted and it makes them more valuable.
Well, most of the hand paint is gone.
But this is broken and the hand painting is gone.
We're moving to the big suitcase. I didn't need that many things for a weekend. So what I did was I packed inside my little tiny carry-on, put that inside the big suitcase, then I just checked both the bags. So when I got there, it was easy to negotiate. I didn't have to pull around an empty suitcase, just one, because the other one was inside of this one. But I had an entire suitcase that I could fill up to 50 pounds. This was 50 pounds on the nose. So this will give you a good idea of what 50 pounds is. But always get to the airport if they say 2 hours early. If you've got junk to deal with, be 3 hours early, because that gave me plenty of time to negotiate my junk and figure out where to put it. And the guy at curbside check-in was super sweet, and he allowed me to move things around so that way I didn't have to pay extra. Or you could just pack yourself a scale. This one's
the
good.
The first damage.
Oh no, I think we can fix that.
The whole frame is broken.
It's just on the we can glue that back together.
Maybe.
We got the
so far, this is the only thing damaged though.
Yeah, but that's totally glueable.
This is the original prayer hands emoji.
I was like, I can't leave that. These are from Construction Junction.
We've got a shirt here used to keep things from banging around.
Yeah, that's what that was, we'll say that.
So the brace for the bit.
I got that for $2 for you. Happy
Father's
Day.
That's a steal because around here I find these for like 15 to 20. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
$2. That's what I mean. Like sometimes there was actually things I thought were overpriced at Construction Junction and then stuff that was underpriced. And so when I'm calculating in the fact that it's a pain in the butt to take home, I always buy things that are really good value. So $2 for this totally makes it worth my suitcase. Some people buy t-shirts, I buy junk when I travel. So this is a little spendy. I paid $10 for this piece of salvage, but you know me, I'm kind of obsessed with salvage. And I love it that I could bring a piece of Pennsylvania home with me. So this I'm not gonna sell. I'll wind up milk painting it and find a cute place to put it in the house.
It's like a really tall, skinny corbel.
Yeah, like it probably had something else that came off over here.
Or part of like a piano or something like that, some sort of furniture. $2.99 at the Goodwill.
Yeah, this is the Goodwill in Pittsburgh. They had really great prices there. The bridge I went down, it was called like the Hot Something Bridge.
So we were thrifting the same time and you got blue stuff too.
$5. I know, we were thrifting in sync even though we were miles apart.
Lots and lots of miles.
$5 for that, so that was a smoking deal. Plus, enamel is lightweight, so it's a great thing to junk when you're out of town. I was like, that's really big, and it'll probably get dented a little bit, but you can put junk inside of it. So
it did get a little smashed right here.
It's all right. I'll clean it up. I'm keeping this for me. It's got sheep on it.
Yeah, it was like
this is Vicks Vapor Rub.
You didn't even know?
No. It's got a triangle on the bottom. These I paid like $1 or $2 a piece
Is this a silver butter dish?
Yes. I got that at Goodwill.
Oh, and the top is still.
And guess what it has?
Oh, a glass plate to keep your silver clean.
So these always sell really well for us. And in Pittsburgh, I think it was just a few bucks. What does it say on the bottom?
You paid $2.99 for that.
Yeah, and I'll sell it for like $22, $24.
You know, we don't have a lot of Goodwills close to us up here in Utah. There's a few if you go into Salt Lake area, but we hear a lot of complaints that their prices are going high. But this, I mean, $2.99 for this.
The Pittsburgh Goodwill had really good pricing. I was sad because there was a Salvation Army down the street and I didn't have time to go there.
Oh, this is some fun salvage.
Construction Junction.
Yeah, this is like a pulley.
$2.
That's cool.
So I thought, well, just all I'm going to do with this is just chop this off the top and the bottom, and then I'll just sell it like that, like a candlestick or a little pedestal. Okay. I'm hoping this made it. Now, this is because you broke mine.
Wait, what did I break?
I remember I was super sad because they're expensive. I found this in Pennsylvania. It was $5.
Oh, you're close.
Yeah. Always cheaper to junk. Did it make it?
Made it. Yours was a little bigger that I broke.
Yeah, but $5. I thought it was a great deal, so
yeah,
I'm going to save that.
These can run like $15 to $40 depending on their size.
Yeah.
Just for the dome.
I don't suggest buying things that thin and breakable, but I was willing to take the chance for $5. And the fact that I like wrapped it up and I put it inside something else, and I packed it tight, that's what made it arrive alive.
Look at all these little portals. How many do you have?
So there's like 40. We actually didn't count them. We just estimated. Construction Junction, 50 cents a piece.
These are gonna be great on a lot of furniture.
Yeah, so we'll have to take them and find which screws fit in them.
Watch out for some furniture makeovers coming to you soon with porcelain knobs.
Yeah, original porcelain knobs for 50 cents a piece is a total steal. And I love it because there's so many of them, they'll match. All right, let's see.
Oh, is this a crock?
Yes, and guess what? It's a crock with something packed inside of it.
It's a crock within a crock within a crock?
I paid $5 for that crock, which is great. I sell this size for like $20 all the time.
And, you know, we went to Round Top for picking. I feel like we just need to go back east and hit up all the thrift stores and the yard sales.
Midwest is where it's at. I hear Ohio is really good. But I wasn't in Ohio. It's in Pennsylvania, and I still found junk to buy. And I thought I would sell like a little like Pennsylvania blue collection. And again, this is the junk shop just down the street from the Burger King in Brooksville. I love to support local junkers because if you're going to buy souvenirs anyways, why not support the people that do what you do?
That amber bottle is everything with the ridge on the bottom of it.
I love that. Yeah, I just paid about a couple bucks each for those. I paid $10 for this, which is kind of a lot, but I knew that I could pack inside of it and would keep my stuff alive. And it's gonna stay here. I'll clean it all up and put it probably in the pantry. It's got sheep on it. I mean, it's totally, this is what Pennsylvania looks like. Lots of trees, lots of red barns, and some sheep.
The color on this jar is awesome.
Yeah, isn't that cool? I paid like $2 or $3 for that one too.
What was it, honey?
It's got
tiny little handles on it.
So. This was $2, but it came with I would have totally unscrewed this, but I couldn't get it off. I don't need this. This used to be a lamp. It had a piece of marble that I didn't want that I just left at the Airbnb. I'll show some pictures of what the Airbnb looked like on the outside. It was really cool.
So I could see where you're going with this. This would make an amazing riser.
Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to take this off, and I'll sell that riser for like $20 because that's brass.
Yeah, that's nice.
It's a nice brass riser. It's a nice piece of brass.
It is a nice piece of brass. Was it $5.99 for the whole deal?
Yes. These are like $18 a piece worth, and I got $6. If you calculate it out, it's like $2 a piece, and they're worth between $18 and $19 each. So the price is really good. We'll just clean them all up, sand where one's chipped, and put some hemp oil.
So just some salvage. This would make a great pedestal. It's probably at the top of a porch column, something like that. Looks like it's been outside, so I'm gonna guess porch column. And then this is really great salvage, old. You can tell it's got hand-forged nails on there, and we just don't see stuff like this. Like, all of our old buildings they just get rid of them.
Pennsylvania was gorgeous. The buildings were amazing. I paid $5 each for those. It might sound a little expensive for junk, but for really good salvage, I will spend a little extra.
Well, and a lot of these things, like, if we don't sell them, Jami will keep them.
I hope it arrived alive. Oh no, we got a crack in the top. Well, it was $6.
It's a glueable crack.
It's a glueable crack. It was $6. I think it's still probably worth like 10 or 15.
Even without the lid, it would be an amazing planter.
Yeah.
So it says Red Cliff Ironstone.
We gave you a little bit more than 5 tips for thrifting and junking while traveling, but we hope this inspires you. The next time you're out of town, for any reason, if you've got a little extra time, hit up your local thrift stores and your junk stores and take some souvenirs home that you can sell for a profit, keep to decorate with, and something that you're not gonna throw away, like an old t-shirt or shot glass in a few years.
So everywhere we've gone in the last few years, we've gone thrifting or junking, and we found some great treasures that we still have around instead of like these little tchotchke type things that we're not even gonna keep around after a year or two.
Some things we keep, some things we sell, but we always have fun. Have some fun while you're out junking this summer. I know you guys have vacations coming up. Comment below with the favorite thing you've ever junk or found while you were out traveling. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it and subscribe to Jami Ray Vintage for more
DIY.
Smile. Do you know how much I love you? You put my favorite song on.